Hello, everyone. This is Emily from Uni-edit, and today we're asking the question, which transition words do I need to know for journal papers? The video today will be about 4 minutes in length. Have you ever plugged in an electrical device to charge, left it for a period of time, only to return and find that the connection was bad and the battery is now dead? How frustrating. Making quality connections is important in academic writing too. In writing of all context, organization of your ideas is fundamental to the reader to understand your meaning. The ideas may be useful and impactful, but only with suitable and natural connections can the reader understand your research. Transition words are required to organize ideas. Using transitions appropriately is essential because through these words, the writer shows how ideas are connected. In academic English, the connections between ideas are almost always specified clearly with transitions, and only rarely are connections left up to the reader's imagination. Academic writers must provide these logical connections stated explicitly in the text for their readers. Remember your frustration when your battery didn't charge due to a bad connection? Your readers will be frustrated at your paper if your ideas are connected poorly too. Here, I present most of the common transition words that you need to know for standard academic English. Pay attention to what your goal is for the transition word you choose in a situation. This guide begins with your goal, followed by some transition word options, and an example sentence using one of the transition words. If your goal is to show cause, consider using one of these words: because, since, on account of, for this reason, due to. We arrived a day after we expected because of the stormy weather. If your goal is to show effect, consider using one of these words: therefore, hence, thus, consequently, as a result. The child had paint smeared on his hand. Consequently, we knew who accidentally smudged the bench. If your goal is to show similarity, consider using similarly or likewise. Children ages 2 to 5 must buy a wristband. Similarly, children ages 5 to 12 must have one as well. If your goal is to show contrast, consider using in contrast, on the contrary, however, meanwhile, despite, nevertheless, notwithstanding, though, but, otherwise, on the other hand. Darja is a skilled athlete who is conscientious in his exercise. However, he does not apply that same work ethic to the academic classroom. If your goal is to show clarification, you might consider using that is to say, i.e., in other words. Here's an example sentence. Jesse put the dates on the calendar chronologically. In other words, in the order they would happen. If you wanted to show qualification, consider using almost, perhaps, nearly, maybe, probably, frequently, although. An example for this one. Although June arrived on time, the meeting had begun early, so she was still late. If your goal is to show intensification, consider using one of the following: indeed, in fact, certainly, undoubtedly. As an example, water is important for survival. Indeed, without it, human life would not be able to exist on the earth. If your goal is to provide additional detail, consider in addition, additionally, furthermore, besides, also, further, and, two. Several small towns faced major building damage from the tornado. Additionally, the rural areas of the county suffered structural losses as well. If your goal is to show emphasis or additional detail, you might consider moreover. Here's an example. There were fewer dollars spent on cancer research last year. Moreover, the rates of cancer did not change. If your goal is to show exemplification, consider using for example, e.g., specifically, for instance. The flow of water needs to be altered to prevent erosion. For instance, we need to create terraces. If your goal is to show temporal, consider using then, next, thereafter, earlier, before, afterwards, later, meanwhile, while, immediately, following, simultaneously, subsequently. Following the reading on finding intelligence quotients in primates, we reviewed the current research. If your goal is summarizing, consider, in summary, overall, to sum up, in brief, in sum. An example might be, in sum, we must consume differently to save the planet for future generations. If your goal is to show conclusion, you might consider using in conclusion, to conclude, finally. For example, to conclude, the recycling and reuse of rubber proves to be a beneficial way to spend public funds. Remember, transition words are simplified ways of communicating connections to your readers. The correct use of these within your academic writing is essential. Once again, this is Emily from Uni-edit. We hope you enjoyed this tip. Have a wonderful day.